Hi, my name is Jediah Andreessen, and our senior design team, Titan Inc., participated in the ASCE Concrete Canoe Competition and received third place in the regional competition. Our team consists of myself, advisor to constraints, Nicole Rogers, mixed design and testing, Izzy Tim, structural calculations, Hayden Quinn, hull design, Minji Kim, hydraulic modeling, Tyson Hymas and Rex Geyer, environmental design and testing. Typically, the competition changes the constraints on the mix design and loading conditions to create a unique experience every year. The competition was different this year due to COVID, as we did not build and compete with an actual canoe. Instead, the competition council added what are called enhanced focus areas to allow for 100% remote format. Our enhanced focus areas were to complete a hydraulic model to test efficiency for selected hull shapes and to mitigate the concrete waste produced in the lab in a more efficient manner.
The first step to the canoe project is to choose a hull shape, which is done with hydraulic testing. Once this is done, a mold starts being constructed. Using the generated CAD files from the hull shapes and a CNC router, we cut cross sections every 6 inches along the hull length, which are slotted into guiding rails to ensure cross sections are parallel to one another. A plastic membrane is secured with caulk to the inside of the cross sections. The flexible material is able to conform easily to the shape while maintaining a stiffness that will support the concrete. A plastic lining, akin to cellophane, will line the inside to cover the seams in the plastic membrane and ensure a smooth finish. Our mix is specially designed to be as low density as possible, while meeting the strength requirements determined in the structural analysis. This is done by using a 50-50 mix of C330 compliant aggregate, in our case shale, and polystyrene beads. The greater the amount of aggregate, the lower the density of the mix, as the equivalent density of the shale and polystyrene mix is lower in density to the cementitious material. The mix also contains fibers that improve tensile strength. A quarter inch layer is placed into the mold by hand, then a carbon fiber mesh, and another quarter inch layer of cement after, for a total hull thickness of half an inch. The entire placement must happen in less than 4 hours to ensure a proper bond is made between the layers of cement. The mix is designed to have a minimal slump to ensure the sides of the hull will remain in place and at the proper thickness. Sample specimens were made for the chosen mix design to ensure it can withstand expected stresses, as well as ensure quality of the mix. Additionally, this curing of specimens verifies the theoretical density we used for the structural analysis.
The environmental aspect of this project dealt with treating washout water that is generated from working with concrete. Currently, the washout water from the concrete is stored in buckets, as you can see in the picture. The buckets are left out until the water evaporates, which usually takes about 2 weeks. This takes up a lot of space and makes it difficult for students and faculty to work in the lab. Our solution was to design a filtration system that could separate the undissolved solids from the washout water. The filtration system consists of 4 stages that have progressively smaller openings as water moves down the filter. Each stage filters out different sized particles. For example, the top filter material consists of a quarter inch sieve that mostly filters out aggregate, while the bottom consists of stormwater pollution prevention material that filters out any undissolved cement. Each filter stage can easily be cleaned by scraping. The hope of this portion of the project was to increase usable space in the lab while mitigating any environmental hazards from building the canoe.
Another enhanced focused area is hydraulic testing. Our team's main goal for this test is to determine the best performing canoe for the competition. These are our 5 3D models drawn in the AutoCAD. Those models are sent to the 3D printers, which took about 15 to 21 hours. This is a model came out of 3D printer with the base filament. This picture shows the scale model versus actual cross sections we had in our lab. We took the supporting filament out, sanded the model, and glued them together. These are the finished look of the models. The models were tested in 12 inches by 24 feet flume, and we collected the data to find the best performing canoe.
The past year was busy as we juggled a changing environment that limited factors of our project, such as the construction of our canoe, as well as in-person discussions. With the environmental improvements, hydraulic testing, mix testing, and project planning for the construction process, we were able to design a product that should last for many years while keeping environmental impact low, as well as improving the lab space for future students.